So I'm Barbara Attwell, teaching crafts at the West Bank Libraries, which are wonderful to support this community project, because there's nothing better to me than doing arts with the community. It really strengthens communities and just makes everybody feel more connected. And it's meaningful and it's also a lot of fun. So today is alcohol inks, and this one is different from a lot of things that I teach because it's very free flow and simple. And a lot of times when I start teaching this, you just get lost in the magic and everybody just takes off and doesn't even look up anymore. So I'm prepared for that. So first I'm going to show you some pictures of some alcohol inks that I've done. And I want to get, so you get the feel of them. These are very loose, very organic. This is one I just started last night. This one has a little bit more control over it. This is an iris. And we've got some that are vaguely ocean representative. But mostly the process is just about having fun. So to start off with, you got your list. So you've got your bottle of alcohol, and I understand there's an alcohol shortage in Austin, according to Gloria. So whatever you have, you know, whatever strength, it's going to work. I have 91%, but the others do work. They're just not quite as diluting. They'll be fine. You need a flat surface, and you need to have it somewhat protected because the inks generally clean off with alcohol, but they can stain. I just put paper down, and you put foil down or plastic. So small containers that we'll put, that one had alcohol in it, that you put alcohol in, put more alcohol in, and some tools, straw, toothbrush. I have a sponge brush. As we get further along, you can see the kind of stuff you can play with. And then the one thing I did not put on this is paper towels. So everybody make sure you get some paper towels right now. I assume I'm hoping everyone has them and have not run out. Let's see. Often get their paper towels. All right, so take your first piece of paper. I think I gave you, did I give you five pieces of paper? Is that right? Five sheets. So we're gonna take your first piece of paper. We're gonna do three systems to start with. The first one, we're gonna put the ink straight on the paper and add the alcohol second. The second one we're gonna do is we're gonna spray the paper with alcohol and then put the inks on. And the third one we're going to do is we're going to paint the alcohol just in areas we want it to be and then put the drops on. So to start off with, let's put alcohol in each of your three containers. Just half an inch, not much. You just need to keep your color separate because as you dip later on, you dip a brush in. If you have a little pink ink, it'll definitely dye the alcohol a different color. And then, does everybody have their spray bottle? So make sure you take the top off of that and fill alcohol in there. We're not going to use very much, so usually half full is about good enough. I have a Trader Joe's hand sanitizer spray bottle, which works really well. All right.
How much alcohol do you put in the containers?
Yeah, put it half an inch in each of the three tubs.
Half an inch, okay, thank you.
Yeah, just a little bit. We'll be dipping our brush in there. So I got everybody, there's three sets, families of colors, and one of them is pink, purple, green, and one is orange, yellow, and green, another is blues and green. So everybody got three sets of the colors that relate to each other, and you would not believe how much time I spent picking the families of colors. So hopefully you're happy with them. All right, so open up your drops. And the first thing you're gonna do, make sure your surface is level. And it does help. I have it on cardboard. I should have said this earlier. To pick it, if you want to tilt it, you can pick it up, but you can also just pick up the piece of paper. You'll see how. So I'm going to just drop several colors of ink on, of each color. And you'll see them kind of migrating a little bit on the paper. The paper is plastic. And you're welcome to watch first if you just want to watch. In fact, that might help. So let's do, so here's some colors right there, three colors. So they're kind of migrating a little bit, but what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take, oh, and your dropper, take your dropper. Everybody should have one of those. Get some clean alcohol, and I'm going to drop onto the inks and watch them run. Now, at this point, I can do many things. I can actually move my paper. I can use my straw. Blow like that. I can, well, we'll wait for the other two to do. So let's start with that. And then at some point, I'm going to let it settle, and eventually it will keep migrating out. And once it gets a little bit drier, I might go back and add another drop. And you'll see the changes it makes. Can you guys see that pretty well? Let's do it in the middle, like that. Okay, so let's start with that. This one is just play. You're not trying to make it look like anything. It's mostly fun and hypnotic. Anybody have an ooh moment already? Ooh, look at that. And then if at some point it settles down and you want to add more color, you can just keep adding color. It's kind of almost impossible to mess these up. I did notice this is different. I usually use a brand called Pinata, which you can get a whole set on Amazon. These are a little bit more serious, and they don't spread quite as much as the others. So I have to kind of help them a little bit. Now, one thing you want to do is I always let them run off the paper. So you can see, I've got some inks here. I'm gonna let them run off the edge because in composition, tapping the extra ink off, you always go over the edges. Now, something you can do easily later is you can trim your pieces down. Quite often, after it's all done, there's a part of it that I think, oh, this is the best part of all, and I cut that piece out. Is everybody stuff spreading okay with their weaker alcohol? Oh, that's nice. I like that. I have been trying every now and then to make Christmas cards with red and green this way, but that one doesn't, it's not quite as successful. Let's see what we got. Okay, so what I want you to do with this one is just set it aside for the moment because we're going to work with it again after it dries up a little bit. I have a beautiful little section of peach over here. I really like it. So move it off to the side and take paper number two. Now this time we're going to spray, I'm going to use my sprayer and I'm going to spray the whole piece of paper with alcohol. Get it really pretty good and wet. This is kind of the most fun way to do it. All right, and then you'll start with your three colors again, and they will already migrate really fast. Make little geodes. And you can drop them inside each other, you can drop them next to each other. I think I might go with the geode feel here. If they don't spread enough, then you can add another drop in the middle. Ooh. That's made little flowers. I got a little too much alcohol in there. So mine, when I started, all completely ran together because I had a lot of alcohol in there, which is actually kind of cool too. But now I'll go back and put some more colors in. And when you get the Yupo paper, you can use either side. I wish you guys could show me these, but you can't because they would drip all over everywhere. Show me what you're doing. Ooh, I got a nice brown in there. These are the same inks that you get in Sharpies. And some people actually will dissect a Sharpie and get some ink out of it. Ooh, that purple's nice. Some more of that. And sometimes when the alcohol just kind of half dries, it spreads really nicely. And it'll hit the other color and kind of go around it instead of blend. Online, you can also buy a blending solution, but alcohol works fine, I find. So my purple's not spreading that well, so I'm gonna keep adding some drops in the middle of the purple. I don't know why it's doing that, but. Ooh. That is crazy. So we're recording the video right now. So after we get through a few of these, we will turn on so everybody can talk too. So that'll be nice to hear. Ooh, I haven't gotten that one before. So every time you add drops in the middle, it's gonna spread out what's already there. That geode effect. All right, so let's get to a stopping point on this one, and I'll show you the third way, and then we'll go back and play some more with the ones we have. Also, I forgot to tell you, some people may want to wear gloves, which of course I got out to remember, but it will wash off with alcohol, so. Okay, one more round and then we'll get the next one out. All right, so let's move that one off to dry. Wow, and wild and woolly. And we will learn to do the third one, which I'll be right back. I gotta get my paintbrush. Sorry about that. I had one out here, I don't know where it went. All right, so everybody ready with their third one? My daughter's laughing at me. So you want to dip your paintbrush, and it doesn't matter what kind of paintbrush, in clear alcohol. And then what it's going to end up looking like this. So what I did here is I painted only where I wanted the color to go. So if I wanted to do an iris again, I'm going to just paint. It's a little hard to see. I'm going to paint one petal. And since it's clear and clear, you kind of have to take a guess. And then I will drop in one color in that area. And I don't know why my purple is not spreading very well. Some colors spread much easier than others. And I'm going to roll it around. You can see this, and it's going to hit the edges of the alcohol where I painted it. And it won't go any further. Unless there's a ton of alcohol. So this way I kind of get a color field, but it stays in one shape. And once it's all mixed on that spot, I will stop. Let's see, I might want to get a little bit more down to the further reaches. Like that. I still see I missed some of the edges of the alcohol, so I'm going to keep running until it gets further. And that's about my outline right there. And then it'll settle into a nice color. And then I can put, this is really fun, like maybe I want to put a little color in the middle of the iris and maybe a little green. There's still some alcohol at the bottom that I see, so I'll do that. And now I might blow it some, and then I'll pick my paper up and mix it some more. Like that. Okay, so try that one. Paint one shape on in clear alcohol. And then put your colors in that. And I will add, also keep dropping alcohol in, make it spread a little more. And meanwhile, you can glance up at your other two and look how much they've changed since you put them down. So since iris leaves or petals often have a center area, I just blew down the center area and it made it a shape, which is really nice. I might turn it and blow in some of the darker edges. It's nice. A lot of people will use hot air guns, which are a lot like a hairdryer, but they have a lot less, they move a lot less air. It's much more gentle. Now on this one, as it starts to dry out a little bit, you can add some more color and it won't move quite as much, but it still will be pretty active. My green spreads really well. I like that. That was like a comet. All right, so we'll put that one away for a moment. We're gonna come back to all three of these. And I'm gonna show you one more technique, which is, this is one. Oh, one more technique. Sorry, take your fourth one. And this time, we're gonna first do a wash. So what we're gonna end up with is, I said I teach three, I'm gonna teach four. Kind of more of a background to a painting. So in this case, I will take, let's see, let me take green and squirt it on without anything on there and get a paintbrush full of alcohol. And I'm just gonna paint just like it's watercolor. And then I might switch to, let's see, a purple, another color. And this is when you wanna rinse your brush off, keep your brush in. This color will be the lime green, this one will be the purple, so you don't mix colors so much. That's why you have three jars. And you can mix them all the way through if you want. Then my last color I have is green. I'll be using all the three colors. So we're gonna start this one with just washes and you wanna go over the edge. Like that. And you can drip it off onto some paper towel. What? Uh-oh. Ignore that. I'm sorry, that was a commercial interruption. We need to get rid of our landline. All of a sudden our phone number is out there again. That's the 10th call for today. All right, so here you've got kind of a wash going on and you can blow on it a little bit and we're gonna put some more drops on top of it in a minute. So it's just kind of a background feeling. This is almost the closest you can get to a real painting on these. And I like to do this if you have blues and greens, it makes a nice ocean. Mine's already dry. All right, so it's a little bit dry. So what I'm gonna do now is take my toothbrush, if you have it, and dip it into some inks, I mean, into some alcohol, just like this. And I'm just gonna spatter it. Woo, that's some amazing things. It becomes bubble land. And now, because it's still a little bit wet, I might want to add in some colors in the middle of my bubble land. Ooh, it's turning into a nice peach, like that. Ooh, nice. And in some places, again, where if it's not running enough, and you just put another drop of alcohol on it. You can also, with these kind of brushes, you can also dab them if you want a little bit. I'm not as crazy about that as not using it. I like it a little bit better when it just goes wild. All right, so once you've done that, now we'll go back and we'll take your very first one, which should be dry by now. And we'll do the same thing with the toothbrush and spatter alcohol on it. And watch it change. So you can, the lesson here is you can always reactivate it. I've got a glare on there, don't I? You can always just reactivate the inks at any time, which just makes it really fun. So I might actually go back on my first one and add a little bit more of a color. My paper warped a little bit. And maybe I'll put a sprayer on that new color. Let's see what happens with that. So that's all your techniques. When you're completely done, you can do things like, here's a dry one. If I wanted to, I could actually outline in black Sharpie or any Sharpie and really make it pop like that. Make the whole iris, which is a fun way to do it too. And you can also trim them. So, like I said earlier, so many times I will actually trim my pieces to cut out the very best part. Ooh, some of this is great. Okay, Gloria, I think that's it. Now we can, instructions over.